G'day, Brett McFall here with another Uncommon View. And in the footage I'm about to show you, it's taken from a live event of mine where attendees in the audience had paid $8,000 to be part of a learning experience. 2 days here and then some more training later on. And I'm going to give you a glimpse as to the sort of things that I was teaching to those folks so that you can actually start and learn these things as well. In this lesson you're about to learn now, it's about how to actually create your own expert empire. In fact, it's the first step to creating your own expert empire, which means that if you want to create your own coaching business, consulting business, then there are some things you need to know. And I'm going to tell you the very first thing you need to get sorted. Now, if you don't get this sorted, everything else is hard. It's the difference between working like a 12-hour day and a 2-hour day. The 2-hour day is when you get it right, and 12 hours is when you've got it wrong. I'm going to tell you why that happens and how to avoid that happening in your case. So I'm going to take you live right now to the seminar room, and you get to see behind the closed doors of my training, where I'm going to show the audience how to the first step to creating their own expert empire, and I hope you enjoy it very much. Here we go.
So the 7 steps. All right. Firstly, does the world need less education or more education? I'm going to try that again. Does the world need less education or more education?
More.
Thank you. That's the sort of answers I need. Thank you. Of course it needs more, doesn't it? Are people working at their absolute best?
No.
So these are so you're all coming back with the same answers. Isn't this amazing? Does the world need to work harder or smarter?
Smarter.
Really? That's where you come in. This is where you come in. You're either going to be the expert to help those people, or you're going to facilitate other experts to help them. Making sense? Yes or yes?
Yes.
All right, this is where you come in. We know there's a need for it. Okay. So step one, choose your niche. Just like in my internet system, you got to choose your niche. All right, not your product, your niche. You choose your group of people. Got to choose your group. You got to decide which group you're going for. Here's a question for you by the late, great Gary Halbert. If you and I have a food stall and are in competition with each other at the local fair, what advantages do you want in order to win? Think about it. What advantages do you want? Talk to me. Good food, thank you.
Position.
Huh? Better presentation. What's that?
Service,
better service, yeah. Good marketing, yes. A USP, which means something unique, a unique selling proposition, yeah?
Hungry customers,
yes. Because here's my answer. You can have whatever advantages you want. I just want one thing, a starving crowd. It's an awesome example by Gary Halbert, and it paints the picture of really what you need. Because all the answers you gave me, better marketing, USP, it's all correct. But you have a starving audience, a starving crowd, a hungry crowd, you win. So your goal is, how do I find the hungry crowd, the starving people in your niche? How do you do that? If you can do that, you'll win, even if your product isn't the best. By finding the starving crowd, that is your success strategy. People who want it so badly, they're prepared to come here on a weekend like this and sit in a seminar like this for 2 days. You want this badly, yes or yes?
Yes.
You've got to find yourself a starving crowd. So you can either work 12 hours a day really, really hard, or you can work 2 hours. Which one do you want?
Two.
Surely pick the two. Surely pick the two. You know, life is so wonderful that if you're choosing to work 12 hours, that's a different equation than if you have to work 12 hours. I'm going to try and suggest to you, try and work two. It's two a day. Then do whatever you really want to do with your life, all right? Maybe it's choosing to work more, maybe it is. But if it's not, wouldn't it be nice to have the freedom to do whatever you really want to do? And maybe it's doing nothing. Maybe it's taking a break. Maybe it's spending with family. You know what it is. But if you go for the starving crowd, you'll do it in just 2 hours a day. If you don't have a starving crowd, it'll take you 12 hours a day because you have to work so damn hard to get that business off the ground. If you've ever tried to make a business work and it's just not gelling, either you need to learn more or your crowd isn't starving. Either you need to learn more or your crowd isn't starving. And when you tap into that starving market, things happen fast. This is the key. Things happen fast. My question to you would be, can you paint me a picture, if I was to come to you right now, can you paint me a picture of who your market is? And if right now that's vague, that's no good. You need a clear picture. I can tell you exactly who my market is. They are generally between 35 and 65, sometimes 70. Look around this room. Generally, that's the age group of this room. Happens to every single event I hold. It's not the young people coming through at all. Occasionally, a few. But generally, you're over 35. Generally, you're in a job. Most people in a job, a small section are actually in their own business. Who want to get out of that business? I can tell you what their attitudes are. I can tell you what their doubts are. I can tell you what their dreams are, because I know the market intimately. So for me to create solutions for that market is very, very easy, and they sell like crazy as soon as I do. Because I've got a starving crowd, and I can paint you a picture of who they are. So you need to be able to do the same. And if you don't know what they look like, what they sound like, who they are, then what are you going to do? Find out, right? Find out. Tell me what they want, not what you want to sell them. Maybe write the question down if that's all right. Yep. Tell me what they want. And if you can't answer that question right now, then you've got to find out what it is. You should know what they want. Because if you don't know what they want, there's no way you're going to be able to help those people. Often people come to me with their great product idea. I've got an awesome idea for a product. What do you think of it? Well, it's an idea, and it sounds like it's good. Do you think it's going to work? I have no idea. I no longer get into that game of predicting what's going to work, because I've had experience where I failed myself, because when I went for the product first and it failed, I think, well, hold on. I was sure that was going to work, but I didn't know enough about the market. I couldn't paint you a picture. I was saying them what I wanted to sell them, not what they wanted. Here's the thing. You only ever really need about 1,000 customers. Out of all the people in this wide world, you only need about 1,000 customers. Because 1,000 times 3,000 equals 3 million. Is that okay? Then you can retire, right? Or keep on going. You choose. But if you get to $3 million, is that okay? For most people, this is life-changing. $3 million allows you to have a nice life. Now, when you get to $3 million, I will suggest you actually want to go much further, but get to $3 million first, then make it. But 1,000 customers is all you really need. 1,000 customers is easy to handle. They're easy to get, once I show you how. But that's what you need. You need a starving market that you can get 1,000 customers from. Something else you want to know is, where is there evidence that this market is paying for help? That's what I'd be asking you. What evidence do you have that they're actually paying for help already? We don't want to go into a market where we're going to have to recreate the wheel and try and get a market which are total freebie seekers and try and get them to pay. No. That's too hard. That's a 12 hours a day deal. So are they buying books? Are there books out there in bookshops that these folks must be buying? Because if there are books produced in any of your bookstores, you know that there's a market. Publishers do not publish books without doing research first. So if the topics are in a bookstore, that's a good sign. You can go to Amazon right now and find out what is selling on Amazon. You can go category by category on Amazon and find out what are the best sellers on Amazon. Tells you instantly, that's a market. Good or good? So these are really good signposts for you to start questions to answer, because if you haven't got a good answer for these, it's going to be obvious why you might be struggling. All right.